Hi there, my name is Dan. Now there are loads of videos here like this one on my channel, but if you want more, check out my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. Hey, in this video we're going to look at making a pie chart infographic. So instead of having a line chart like we did in the last one and just having it reveal, we're going to have a pie chart, kind of like the little slices popping out. So to do it, we're going to create a new composition. Okay, and we're going to background color. I'd like to change it to white, but remember we can't do it here. We need to click OK and add a new layer solid. There we are there. And make sure it's white. I'm going to call this one background. Okay, and I'm going to lock it. And he's going to sit there in the background. Okay, so to do a pie chart, we're going to grab the circle tool. And remember, have nothing selected down here. Otherwise, the circle will just become a mask. I'm going to pick a fill color. Okay, so we might pick any color, as long as it's green. Click, hold, and drag out a circle. Okay, so we've got our circle. Back to my black arrow. Now, for this trick to work, you really need it in the center of your composition. Even if later on you're going to move it around, to start off with, the radial wipe needs to have the circle in the center. To do it, open up your align panel. So go to Window, go to Align. It's not already open. Where's my align? There it is down here. Okay, it's set to composition, so it means it's going to go center in the middle and in the middle. So it's perfectly in the middle. It's going to help us use this thing called a radial wipe. Okay, so we've got one slice here, and I'm going to rename this one, and this one's going to be called the base. I'm going to close that up to make it look pretty. I'm going to copy and paste this one. I'm going to right click this one and call this one slice. All right, and this top one here, I like to make a little bit bigger and change the color. So I'm going to go into here, and what you'll notice is that I'm going to increase the scale of it, but watch what happens. It's going to scale from the center point. Okay, and this is a bit of a pain when you draw things. That was the center of the composition originally. Now we've removed it around. You want to use the pan behind tool. Just make sure that this guy is in the center. Do you remember the key I hold down to move the anchor point around? It's Command on Mac and Control on PC. It just snaps to the center. Now when I scale it, it's going to go from the center. I'd like it to up to about maybe 120. It's just going to be the pie slice is going to be slightly bigger than the rest of it. So I'm going to twirl it down now. Here's my slice, change the color. Okay, I'm gonna click on it. And where is my, click on contents, click on ellipse. Okay, and up the top here, right, black arrow actually, with it selected. And let's pick a new color. What color, any color. Oh, I don't know. Okay, I've clicked that one. So we've got our slice, it's a little bit bigger. Now we need to add the radial wipe. So over here in your effects and presets, type in radial. Radial wipe is what you're looking for. So it's to the bottom here, drag it on, and there he goes there. Okay, so if he wasn't in the center, if I undo before I add it, and I put this guy down here, and then I add the radial wipe, you'll end up with this problem. Can you see it does it from the center of the composition, not the center of my circle? So I'm gonna go undo, put him back. Now I add radial wipe to him. And now when we drag out the completion, hey, it's gonna do a cool like little pie slice thing. Now we're gonna play around with the timing. So at the beginning of my play timeline here, I'm gonna get it to play for a little bit. Actually no, at the beginning here, I'd like to set the start the stopwatch so I can set a keyframe, and I'd like to set it to be complete 100%. It means it's all gone, okay? So it means it's all the way through and you can't see it. Okay, so it's 100%. And then maybe about 1 second into it, I wanna put in a manual keyframe. So down here, okay, and your keyframes, where are we? Effects, there it is there. Radial wipe, twirl that down. There it is there, I'm gonna put in a diamond to say don't move. So between here and here, it doesn't go anywhere. Okay, and maybe after half a second, it's gonna expand out. Okay, and to get it to expand out, we're gonna get it to expand out how far? It's on the wrong side, I realize we're gonna flip that around, that's okay. So it's gonna be about, actually, I'm gonna get mine to go at 80%. You'll have to calculate what your percentage is for your bar graph, okay, and work it back into percentages. So I'm gonna do that. Now what we're gonna do is, because at the moment, watch this, it's kind of cool, okay, but it's coming down that way. So what I wanna do is start it so it's over this side here. So there's this one here called start angle. I'm not gonna animate it, I'm just gonna move the whole thing around to about there. So it kind of comes out that side. Yep. Okay, and it's coming from the top the bottom up. So I wanna switch that around from clockwise to counterclockwise. I have to play around with my angle again, so it's about there. All right, so I want it to do this. All right, and the last bit of motion is I'm going to make these a bit closer together. I'm going to select them all. I'm going to right click them, go to velocity, and I'm going to change this to 70%. So the easing is lovely. Cool. And the last little thing is I'm going to add my motion blur, turn it on for the project, turn it on for the layer. Okay, I'm going to toggle back to, that's okay. So watch this. Is it as exciting? Maybe not. Maybe it needs a bit more time. Yeah, it's kind of cool. All right, I haven't actually turned my motion blur on. Which one did I turn it on for? Nothing. I avoided the whole bit. Okay, so that, my friends, is how to do a pie chart. Now you could duplicate this slice by copying and pasting. And what we'll do is we'll twirl down the keyframes just to see where they are. So he kind of pauses for a long time and then just pops out. Okay, so what I'd like to do is drag this along a bit so the timing's a bit off afterwards. So watch, so this one starts and then this one's gonna go off a bit afterwards. Let's open up him as well. So he starts and then about there that one starts. So to make it look different, there's a couple of things we need to do. With it selected with a black arrow, I can pick a different color. Any color. Okay, and what I'll do is I'll get him to rotate around. Now I've got to make sure that I'm actually on a keyframe there. Watch this. If I start playing around with like the how long it's been acting for, it's gonna add a new keyframe. So what I want to do is hold down my shift and I want to get to here. So how far is it gonna pop out? This one here is only gonna pop out a little bit. So it's gonna go pop out like 93%. Okay, which is cool. And I want to start with the start angle. So I don't want it to start there. I want it to start where that one finishes, about there. Nice. Okay, so it's gonna go zip, zip. Okay, and you could do a few different ones kind of all popping out by duplicating it. All right, that is how to make a pie chart infographic. Let's hit save and I'll see you in the next video.